Hello, my name is Keshwani.
That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I.
Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the TEAS. Starting today, we'll begin solving all the math problems that you will find in this new edition, the 6th edition. We have already solved all the problems, all the math problems from the 5th edition. If you need extra practice, if you want to solve some more problems, as I said, to get some extra practice, you will find solutions to all the problems that appeared in the 5th edition from day number 1 through 80. From day number 1 through 80, just type in T's math day 1 through 80. Any date that you wish, every once in a while I'll tell you where you will find some extra problems to work on. And the more you practice, of course, the better prepared you're going to be. But today we'll begin with this book here, the 6th edition. In the 6th edition, I'm going to start numbering them from day 101. So listen carefully. Today we're going to start a new series, beginning from day 101. There exist no videos from 81 through 100. They do not exist. I just don't want to start a new series with 81. I would prefer to have 101. So let's get going, okay? Enough of the talk. Today is going to be our lesson number 101. Day 101, we are on page number 66. Let's see what they have to say. It is important that you have the book in front of you. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You are going to need it. There is no such thing as preparation for TEAS if you do not own the official study manual, or as they call it, the study manual. That's right. I thought they call it study guide. But study manual, as I said, make sure you purchase it. 6th edition, that's what you're going to need. Turn to page 66. Page 66 is where the story begins, where the math portion begins. It says convert each decimal to a percent. Convert each decimal to a percent. Convert each decimal to a percent. Before we solve the problems that are given in the book, let's take a look at a couple of simple scenarios so that we can understand what's going on. For example, convert decimals to a percent. For example, everyone knows that 0.5, how much is 0.5? Well, in fraction, of course we know 0.5 is half. 0.5 is half of something. Half of something is 0.5. And we also know, of course, that half of something is 50%. That is something we already know. Everybody knows that if you have a half of something, you got 50%. The question is, how do we go from this decimal form to a percentage form? And if you understand that part, that's what we need to do here. Well, here's a decimal form, 0.5. And if you want to go to 50%, we're going to have to take our decimal and multiply it by 100. And when you multiply your figure here, the decimal, by 100, what's going to happen is that here's your decimal, 0.5. Since we are multiplying it by 100, and 100 has two zeros, that means we're going to have to pick up our decimal and move it to the right two places. 1, 2. The decimal is going to end up here. Decimal ends up here. And then in this empty space that we have, we need to put our zero, which is why 0.5 becomes 50. 0.5 times 100 is going to become 50%. 50%. Let's do one more, shall we? Let's do one more. This time, let's do 0.25. 0.25. Again, 0.25. Everyone knows 0.25 is 1/4, is 25%. A quarter of something is 25%. Of course, we know that. The question again is, how do we go from here to here? Well, same as before. We're going to take our decimal that is given to us, and we're going to multiply it by 100. And by doing so, by virtue of multiplying this figure by 100, because 100 has two zeros, we need to move the decimal place two spots to the right, 1 and 2, just like before. So here's our 0.25. Here's our 0.25. We want to convert this into percentage. We need to multiply it by 100. And as we do that, we're going to have to take our decimal and move it to the right two places. Watch what happens now. So here's the decimal, 1 and 2. It ends up here. 0.25 becomes 25. Of course it's 25, Everyone knows, as we said before, that a quarter of something is 25%. In other words, 0.25 when converted into percentage is 25%. So the idea is, whatever decimal that is given to us, if we need to convert it, if we are asked to convert that into percentage, simply take the decimal, whatever it is that is given to us, multiply by 100, and by doing so, we're going to have to move the decimal to the right two spots, and you're done. That's all it is. It's as simple as that. Let's look at the problem that is given in the book. Very simple, very straightforward. The very first one that they give us is 1.22. Watch what happens. 1.22. No big deal, same as before. We are being asked to convert this quantity from decimal to percent. Well, if you want to convert this from decimal to percent, we simply have to multiply by 100. And if we do that, we're going to have our quantity that's given to us. We're going to pick up our decimal, as we have done before, as we have done twice before. We're going to simply pick it up and move it two spots, and wherever we finish, that's our answer. Decimal ends up here. Decimal ends up here, and of course, zero is here. So what do you have when you have 1220? That's simply, we end up with 1220, but that's just 122%. That's just 122%. In other words, 1.22, when converted into decimal, 1.22 is simply 122%. Let's do one more, shall we? The next one we have is 0.384. Again, the same thing. It doesn't matter how weird the quantity looks, no matter how strange it looks, the concept, the methodology, the notion, the idea, the theory does not change, of course. The theory is simply, when you have to convert something from decimal to percentage, one simply multiplies the given quantity by 100. And by doing so, one has to move the decimal to the right two spots, two places. That's all. That's the end of the theory. So let's go. We have 0.384. We're going to multiply it by 100. And of course, by now we know what's going on. We can pick up some speed here. So here we go, 0.384. We have just multiplied the quantity by 100. And 100 has two zeros. 100 has two zeros. That tells us that we need to pick up our decimal and move two spots. 1 and 2 is going to end up here. It ends up between the two fours. In other words, 0.384 times 100 is 34.4. In other words, 0.34. Oh, it was 384, wasn't it? Blast it. Bloody hell, I tell you. In other words, 0.384 when converted into decimal, 0.384 when converted into decimal, it is simply 38.4%. 38.4%. That should have been 38.4. So we simply take our given decimal, 0.384, multiplied by 100, which becomes 38.4, and therefore 0.384 when converted into percentage becomes 38.4%. Let's do one more, one last one, and then we'll move on to something else. How about 5.28? What is that in percentage? Well, 5.28, if you want to convert into percentage, we need to multiply by 100, and when we multiply by 100, since 100 has two zeros, we're going to have to take our 5.28, we're going to have to pick our pick up our decimal, which is right here, and move it to the right two spots. 1, 2, it ends up right here. It ends up right here, and after that we have to, of course, if it makes you feel better, put a zero there if you like, and essentially it is 528. 5.28 is essentially, well, it's not essentially 528, it is 528. 5.28 times 100 is 528, therefore, 5.28, when converted into percentage, is simply 528%. That's all. Which makes perfect sense, because if I have one pizza, What percentage of the pizza do I have? Well, I have a one whole pizza. What percentage of the pizza do I have? I have 100%. Well, obviously I have 100%, because if I want to convert a 1 into a percentage, I'm going to take my 1, which I'm going to write it as 1.00, that's the 1. And if I want to convert into percentage, I'm going to multiply by 100. And since 100 has, 2 zeros here, I'm going to pick up my decimal, 1.00. I'm going to pick up my decimal because we're multiplying by 100. I'm going to pick up my decimal and move it 2 spots. 1 and 2, there you go. 1.00 times 100 is 100%. Of course, if you have a whole of something, that's 100%. Everyone knows that. Everyone understands that. Let's move on to the next concept, shall we? Let's move on to the next concept, which is convert percent to a decimal. Convert percent to a decimal. Before we did decimal to percent, now we're going to do convert percent to a decimal. Now listen, here's what I'm going to do. I've changed my mind. As you watched the previous series, which was the series, as I showed you before, based on the math problem that appeared in the fifth edition of the exam. As you watch this series based on the fifth edition, day number 1 through 80, you will see that in that series also, I made a point of making all the videos around 10 minutes long, 10 to 20 minutes, that's all. The idea is for you to be able to sit there anywhere you to get a time, anytime you have a downtime at work, waiting in the doctor's office, anywhere, you pull out whatever it is, tool that you have there, your iPod or whatever it is, and do a lesson. We're going to call them a lesson, and we're going to do one lesson at a time, and we're going to learn one concept at a time. The concept that we learned today was how to convert, what was it? I forget now. How to convert decimal to percent. The percent to decimal is a new concept. I'm not going to do it today. Let's just call it a day here. We're going to end the video. In the next video, we'll learn how to convert, how to go the other way around. Not from decimal to percent, but from percent to decimal. If we're given percent, how do you convert to decimal? We'll do that in the next video. Okay? Bye now.